Hi friends, welcome back to the Big Joy of Learning with Bijoy Ji. In this session, we will discuss in detail about the value added amount and calculation of VAT liability with illustrations of transactions in a construction company. Value added amount on which VAT is calculated is the total of all amounts added to the product without paying VAT. Here, value is cost plus the profit. Let us see the scenario of a construction company. Many people ask, if you don't pay VAT on labor charges and many other costs, then how can you collect tax on it? While collecting VAT from the end user, it is always done on the final price of the product. It is only for the registered dealer that the VAT is on the value added amount. Let us see this with some figures. A builder sells a commercial building for 100,000 and collects 5% VAT of 5,000. The breakup cost of the building was 35,000 on material, 30,000 indirect expense and 20,000 labor. He adds 15,000 profit and sells it for 100,000. Let us assume that VAT was paid on material cost of 35,000 and on 20,000 indirect expenses. Here, the value added amount is 10,000 indirect expenses for which VAT was not paid, 20,000 labor cost and 15,000 profit, which comes to 45,000. The VAT liability of the builder on this building is 5% of 45,000, that is 2,250. We will arrive at the same figure if we calculate the VAT liability as VAT collected minus VAT paid. Here, the VAT collected is 5% of the sale value, that is 100,000, which comes to 5,000, minus the VAT paid 5% of material cost, 35,000, and 5% of 20,000 indirect expense, which comes to 2,750. So the VAT liability is 5,000 minus 2,750, that is 2,250. You can see that in both the methods, the VAT liability of the builder is only 5% of the value added to the building without paying VAT. Since we are discussing contracting business, I would like to put light on some insights here. I have been getting several queries on what amount to be considered as contract amount for the contracts having VAT. The contract value to be considered for any calculation is the amount before VAT. In our example, the contract value is 100,000 and not 105,000. So, wherever calculation that consider the contract value, we have to consider the value before VAT. For instance, insurances, bonds, securities, etc. VAT is a liability of the contractor which he collects from the customer and pays to the authorities on behalf of the customer. The contractor does not have any consideration on this amount, so it should not be considered as part of the contract value. Let us conclude this session understanding these two points. The VAT liability of a registered dealer is always on the value added amount, and for the final customer, it is on the full price of the product. The contract value of any contract to be considered for any calculation is always the price of the contract before VAT. This is Bijoy signing off for now. Until we catch up in the next video, your subscription, likes, shares and comments will be much appreciated. Thank you for your time and have a big joy of learning.